What is a boilerplate affidavit? Hello friends, my name is Ikuya. I'm a U.S. licensed attorney focused on my practice exclusively on U.S. immigration and trademark law. My law office, aka Poku Law PLLC, is located in Manassas, Virginia, but I represent fabulous immigrants in all 50 states throughout the United States, and I handle all types of U.S. immigration law matters. So I had an interesting follow-up question on the boilerplate affidavits video I did, stating that boilerplate affidavits are useless for, you know, trying to prove any type of fact in U.S. immigration. So we spoke a little bit about birth certificate. So normally the USCIS, that's the United States Citizenship and Immigration Services, prefers birth certificates that were issued contemporaneously with the birth of a child. So for example, if you are a father who's a US citizen and you're trying to file a petition for your son who is in another country, first of all, you need to show that you qualify to seek that benefit. So how do you show this? That of course you're a US citizen, number one, and secondly, that you are related to the person you're filing for. So in this case, you need to show documentary evidence of the fact that the person, the beneficiary you're filing for, is your son. And how do you do this? You need a birth certificate, and you would need a birth certificate that was issued contemporaneously with the birth of your son. So if your son was born in 1987, they're not looking for a birth certificate that is registered in 2021, you know, just when you were trying to file an application. Okay, that always makes them think that it was, you know, fraudulently obtained, because probably you are seeking the benefit. You went and had this birth certificate manufactured. So usually they would like a birth certificate that was issued also in the same year in which the child was born. So if it was born in 87, the birth certificate should have been issued within that same year. However, as you know, for places like Ghana, some people do not register their births, and so it's even listed on the Department of State's website that it's not uncommon to find that Ghanaians would only go for birth certificates when they need them for immigration purposes or for any other purpose. They usually do not have birth certificates. Okay, so if you do not have a birth certificate that was issued contemporaneously with your birth, you usually would have to support your application with what is known as a secondary evidence, and you do this through affidavits. And the affiant, or the people who are swearing the affidavits, need to speak about personal knowledge of the birth of the child and the fact that the father is actually the father. Okay, so when you are writing such affidavits, don't copy and paste. Don't use boilerplate, you know, don't use templates, you know, things you've copied from the internet or whatever, just stating that, you know, my name is so-and-so, and yes, the son was born on 1st January 1987, and he's the father. It just lacks the details they are looking for. They need personal knowledge. They need details, you know, everything about the birth, how you learned about it, what your relationship is with the, you know, the petition or the beneficiary, details surrounding the birth, for them to know that yes, you actually witnessed it. You want your affidavit to be credible, so avoid boilerplate affidavits. Don't copy and paste from the internet, and don't make the affidavit sound so impersonal. You know, it has to be your first-hand knowledge. So that's what I mean by you know, using very probative types of affidavits. I hope you guys found this video helpful, and I hope it clarifies a lot for you. If you need my assistance, please don't hesitate to call me on 802-7800-564. I will be very happy to assist you. I'll see you in the next video. Take care and bye.